The Seymour Micro uses a tag name database to help you manage and keep track of the tags you define. A tag is just a name for a memory location on a device. Objects like push buttons write values to the tags, which can be located on a PLC, another device, or even internally on a Seymour Micro. In this example, we have three oven push buttons, which enable ovens, which are really just writing values to tag values down here on this PLC. We also have a numeric display, which is monitoring this temperature tag on the PLC. If I modify the temperature tag, then that gets reflected in the numeric display. Likewise, if I press a button, that changes the tag down on the PLC. Let's see how this looks in the tag database. From within the project, you can select the tag name database under the Navigation Menus Function tab right here, or under the Database menu item right here. In this dialog, you can filter the display of tags by device. Do you want to show just the internal tags? That's the tags local to the Seymour Micro panel. Or do you want to just show the tags that are specific to a given device? We'll choose all for right now. You can display system tags if you want to. These are tags that are unique to the Seymour panel that allow us some special features. You can even highlight those if you want to. You can also choose to display internal tags or not and highlight them. And you can highlight unused tags, which is a real quick way to find out if you have any extra tags in your project. For example, we see that oven 3 is unused, but we have an oven 3 push button. So that tells me there's probably an issue with my project somewhere that I need to go debug. Let's go take a quick look at that. Oven 3, sure enough, oven 3 is using oven 2's tag. We need to fix that. Assign oven 3 to that. Pop back into our tag name database. And now we can see that oven 3 is not highlighted anymore, but we're still not using the pressure tag. That's okay. To create a tag, click on Add. Choose the device this tag will be applied to. Give it a name. Specify the data type. And where it's going to be located on the PLC. And say Add. You can quickly add more and more tags this way. You can also quickly scroll through the existing tags using these arrow keys right here. You can go straight to the beginning, straight to the end. Add a new tag if you want to. Note that if you create an internal tag, you no longer need to specify a memory address. When you're done editing or creating tags, just hit Close and you're back in the tag name database. The Fill Down button is handy if you have a sequence of tags. Suppose we wanted to add some more oven tags, for example. Just hit Fill Down and it automatically adds tags with an index appended. Note that this only works for external tags, not internal Seymour Micro tags, because there's no memory address to increment with the internal tags. All tags in your project are logged in this database, so you always have the ability to quickly and easily manage your tags. Check out the video on importing and exporting tags to see how to take advantage of tags from other projects and how to add large quantities of tags quickly. That's it for this video. Be sure to check out the other videos in this series. And as always, please send us any topics you would like to see covered, or any other comments for that matter. We appreciate the feedback.